Dearly beloved, we're gathered together in the sight of God to join together this man and woman in holy matrimony. Marriage is a divine, distinctive, and enduring institution created by God, superintended by Jesus Christ, and regulated by the Holy Spirit. It is commended in the scriptures to be honorable among all, and therefore, not by any to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, soberly, and in the fear of God. The book of Colossians chapter 3, verses 12 through 17, the Bible says, therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear each other and forgive one another if any of you has a grievance against someone. Forgive as the Lord forgave you, and over all these virtues put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you were called to peace, and be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly, as teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit. Sing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God, the Father, through him. Anthony, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together in God's ordinance in the holiest state of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only to her, so long as you both still live? Tonight, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in God's ordinance, the holiest state of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keeping yourself only unto him so long as you both shall live? In the scripture, it talks about a wedding at the Cana of Galilee, the first miracle that Jesus performed, where he turned water into wine. And it makes us wonder what really happened at that miracle, because it was at that miracle where this couple invited Jesus into their marriage. And that's all I'm instructing you today. Whatever you do, you always keep God first in your marriage. He'll make the difference in your life. And as I counseled both of you, it was obvious that you're all in love with one another. And you're marrying one another out of pure love. And I hardly ever see that anymore. But I'm truly blessed to have counseled you and shared your faith with you, and now shared our faith with me. I want y'all to hold each other's hand. And Anthony, I want you to repeat after me. I, Anthony, take thee tonight to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, and there to do, I give thee my pledge. And tonight I want you to repeat after me. I today take thee, Anthony, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better and for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, and there to do, I give thee my pledge. You have the rings at this time. I can definitely tell you y'all love one another. They do believe that. But if you notice, those rings, they are circular, they have no ending, which means that the love that you have for one another should never have an end. It was in the old Greek days that they would make rings out of Corinthian bronze. And the bronze had to be, first of all, heated to a certain temperature, and then they would scrape the impurities off the top, and then they would heat it again and scrape the impurities off the top. And then they would form the ring after it was beaten and shapen into the ring circular figure. And in saying that, in your marriage, you will be tested. In your marriage, you will have problems, as normal couples do. It's part of the life. But always remember that the circle, that the ring represents, it represents a love that is never broken. And let me tell you something, as I told y'all even in counseling, you invited these people here just to be a witness, not to have the say-so in your marriage.
Amen.
This is y'all's marriage, and it's a covenant between you and God. And when you leave from here, people are going to be trying to tell you how to run your house. You know how to run your own house. And you have to be mindful of that. Look at those rings. And as I advise y'all when I counsel y'all, every morning y'all pray together. Every morning, thank God that y'all found one another and found an everlasting love. And it's the love that both of y'all have for each other that's so beautiful and it's so pure. You hardly see that anymore today. And in your marriage, there will be struggles, there will be trials. But just remember what I took notes of, and I wrote everything down that y'all said. Why y'all wanted to get married. And I asked y'all, what were you expecting from marriage? And I asked you, what were you going to get out of this marriage? And you told me that I just love this woman. You told me I just love that man. So remember those days when you were counseling how y'all love one another. And you'll see God get the glory out of your marriage. We're going to have the lighting of the candles at this time. We're going to have a reading of the lighting of the candles.
The lighting of the unity camp. Kanae and Anthony are going to light their unity camp, a symbol of their relationship and love. The candles from which they light it have been lit by their families to represent their lives to this moment. The lights representing the faith, wisdom, and love that they have received from their parents are distinct, each burning alone. Today, and Anthony will light the center candle to symbolize the union of their lives. As this one light burns undivided, so share their love, be one. May the radiance of this one light be a testimony of their unity. May these candles burn brightly as symbols of their commitment to other, and as a tribute to their family's everlasting love for them.
Thank you. Let us bow our heads in a moment of prayer. Eternal God, the God that sustains our life, the God that keeps us, the God that watches over us. And God, we pray your blessings upon this couple. When they leave from here and they forge their own path in life, we pray, as the scripture teaches us, to trust in the Lord with all thy heart and to lean not to our own understanding, but in all our ways to acknowledge you. And if we do that, you will direct our path. So God, we ask that you would direct their path as they leave from here. As one, they have formed a union and a bond with you. So God, we thank you today for this couple. We thank you for the love that they share with one another. And Father, we thank you for all that you're doing in their life. It's in the name of Jesus that we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Trying to hold each other's hand and gaze deeply into each other's eyes. For as much as Anthony and Tay have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and these witnesses, and in doing have given and pledged their vows to each other, and have declared the same by the giving of the ring, I pronounce them husband and wife, together in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost, you may salute your bride.
Thank you.